What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the Fralix Arms channel. I'm your host, and it's super great to have you guys here. So first, I want to apologize that I haven't uploaded a video in quite some time. I've been super busy with work and all the virus crap and transitioning from working in an office to working at home, and also my other YouTube channel, which is my primary channel. But I'm super glad to be back. Also, I have to tell you guys this. I'm recording this video today because, you know, not only do I feel like I need to, the majority of that feeling comes from the fact that tomorrow I will no longer not be a dad. Tomorrow my daughter is being born. We're having a scheduled C-section. Everything's going to be great and fantastic. So today is my last day of not being a dad, and I wanted to record a video for you guys. And per the title of the video, as you can tell, today we're going to be talking about the amazing Mossberg 500. So before we do anything, let's clear this bad boy. It's officially been cleared. Okay, so now that none of you have your panty in a wad because you don't know if this thing is safe or not, I can assure you that it is 100% safe. So, the Mossberg 500. Developed in 1960 by the Mossberg & Sons company. That is 60 years. Wow, that is awesome. This shotgun is probably, well, it's my second favorite shotgun. Let's just get that straight right now. It's my second favorite. First favorite being my single shot 20 gauge that belonged to my grandfather. And that's why. But this being probably my defense shotgun of choice. I picked this thing out, ordered it, and I love it. I think it's a great piece. I think it's really awesome. 18.5 inch, and I really dig the equal length magazine and barrel. I think that that is just sexy and hot and everything else in between. It's a hammerless design. What can I say? It's a super reliable, super awesome 12 gauge shotgun. I recommend it to anyone that wants one. Direct competitor of this shotgun would be the Remington 870, I believe. Nothing wrong with the Remington 870. Literally, I was completely on the fence about both of them because I was just looking for a cool home defense shotgun because I did not own a 12 gauge at the time. But the deciding factor was simply the fact that the slide release is down here next to where your trigger finger is. That just makes a lot more sense to me. So I believe the Remington one was like up here or somewhere different, and maybe the safety wasn't on the tang. And in my opinion, there's nowhere else a safety should be unless you're talking about an AR-15 or something of that nature, semi-automatic, something like that. I believe the safety should be at the tang, period. I mean, unless you have a pistol grip gun. Like, if this thing had a pistol grip, it'd be really hard. But any kind of stock design like this, tang, safety, 100% every time, no matter what. So, what are some other things I can say about it? It'll hold 7 shells, I think. 8 shells, it'll hold 8 shells, which is awesome. That is super cool. That's a lot of firepower if you have one in the chamber. What more can you ask for? Plastic stock, flat black, receiver, plastic pump, and just a pump action shotgun. Like, I hate it when people are like, this is the scariest noise. Is it really though? Like, people are always like, if someone breaks into the house, oh, I want a shotgun just so I can do this. Yeah, it's fun, but I mean, is that the scariest noise in the world? Is it really? I don't think so. Other than the fact that it's super reliable and super affordable, there's really nothing special about it. You can get them without this heat shield. And I mean, I didn't even know I was buying the one with the heat shield. I just went to the pawn shop that I normally buy stuff at. And I was just like, hey, I want a Mossberg 500, 18.5 inch home defense. And they were like, cool. I didn't really know anything about shotguns until recently, which I've had this firearm for quite some time. And like I said, I apologize for not making a video, but here we are. A stainless steel receiver, plastic stock, plastic trigger assembly, metal trigger, but the trigger assembly here is, the housing is plastic pump. Everything else is stainless steel. And it's got some really nice bluing on it, really nice coatings, strong, sturdy. I see why police officers carry these. Unbelievable aftermarket support. I don't think I'm going to do anything to mine, to be honest. I might put a Magpul stock on it, but I really doubt it. Like, I don't really want to do anything to it. I like it like this. I like the basicness of it, the simplicity of it. That's really it. I have some shooting of this, and I will put that in the video right now. Mossberg 500, brand new, never shot. Let's see what we can do. It's hot.
Yeah.
All right, let me get you some more. Did that kick hard?
Not too bad.
All right, let's load you up with some slugs then. 7 in the mag, 1 in the chamber. It's all you, buddy. Have fun.
Fuck.
You don't have to shoot all 7. Actually, I tell you what, only shoot 3.
3?
Yeah. I'll shoot 3, you shoot 3.
God damn.
And so, yeah, I mean, it cycles rounds. It shoots anything you put in it. It'll handle 3-inch shells, which, I mean, that's a lot. That's what people, you know, tend to like to shoot, I guess, is 3-inch. I've got 2¾-inch that I put through it, which is what you saw me shoot just then. And yeah, I've had it for a little bit. And like I said, the reason I bought it was just for home defense. Now, they do make a better version of this. I say better, a little bit improved. The Mossberg 590 is the better version of this firearm, and it is for police use mainly. It's got more of a rust preventative coating on it. I think it's like a silver type of color, maybe like a gray, you know, where this is all mainly just flat black. I could take it or leave it. The only upgrade that I think I would do to this is put the 590 trigger housing in this, because the 590 trigger housing is all metal. And so a lot of people like to do that upgrade. They take the plastic one out and then put the metal one in. There have been reports of this plastic housing cracking and falling out or whatever. I haven't experienced that with mine, but I also haven't really shot it enough to really test the integrity of this trigger housing. But nevertheless, I haven't had any issues, and it, like I said, that's the only upgrade I would do if I do anything to it. It's got some screws up here at the top. If you want to put an optic on it, go ahead, that'd be great. But I think the factory front sight is fine with me. I mean, it's a shotgun. I'm totally, completely happy and used to a single shot 20 gauge. Going to a pump action 12, that's pretty bitchin' in my opinion. I think that is awesome. So, I didn't want to make this a comparison video, but just for my hunters out there, because I consider myself a hunter now, I'm gonna go turkey hunting hopefully this year for the first time in a long time. I went one time before, but I was really young and I wasn't carrying a gun with me. Do not buy this for turkey hunting. Do not. Like, this is not, several reasons why, but this is home defense. 18.5-inch, you don't want that for turkey hunting. Now, I will show you guys this. Like I said, did not want to make this a comparison video, but I feel like it's worth mentioning. So, if you want to go turkey hunting, you may be looking at this and be like, hey, another one. Kinda. This is a Mossberg Maverick Model 88. I traded a pair of subwoofers for this thing. 28-inch barrel, long guy. But the magazine on this thing is bigger. So in the home defense one, it can handle 8. I think this one can handle 6, maybe, something like that. So yeah, this the 500 is really, really cool, but in the barrel here, there's no threading for a choke, which you don't wanna choke an 18.5-inch barrel anyway. This one, 28-inch barrel, it has, if you can see that, it has a choke in it. I just bought that and put that in there for turkey season. Full choke, and if you've never installed a choke before, it's literally just like a little cylinder. It'll thread into the end of the barrel, and it comes with a little key to tighten it down. Super simple. This one's clear too, by the way. Totally clear. And I like this one. Big differences between this and the 500. Price. This is a poor man's Mossberg 500. I would be totally happy with owning just this. Only thing that I don't like about this shotgun is that the safety is down here by your finger. Not horrible, because if you're right-handed, if you're left-handed, don't buy it. I'm just going to go ahead and tell you, don't buy it if you're left-handed. You're right-handed, not too bad. Push this in, ready to fire. Red dead, ready to go. So you push that, you're good to go. You know what I'm saying? So not horrible. Slide release is in the same spot. Or I guess if you want to call that the slide or the pump or whatever you want to call it. Only other difference is, like I said, tank safety, not here. Trigger housing is pretty much identical. This is pretty much identical. The pump on the 500 here, it's screwed into place, so you can change them out really, really simple. This one's pinned. You can't take it out very easily. But that's okay. Like I said, it's a poor man's shotgun. The Mossberg 500, you can probably get one for about $300. This one, maybe 180, around $200, if you're lucky, about 180. So really, you can buy this and it'll work. And you can get them in all different kinds of configurations. You can get a 18-inch barrel, a 20-inch barrel, a 28-inch barrel, whatever. Doesn't matter. Sights on this one are, you know, just regular iron sights. You got the bead at the very end here. You got this sight. I mean, it works. I've shot this one too. It works fine. And that's really the only differences. I think this, the alloy that they use for this may be a little bit different, but anything that can fit on a Mossberg 500 can go on the Maverick 88. And like I said, I didn't even know I was going to get this gun. My buddy Shane texted me and was just like, "Hey, you want a 12 gauge shotgun pump action?" And I was like, "Yeah." And so we worked out a trade for a pair of subwoofers that I've had them for over 10 years. I had them for over 10 years, and I hadn't used them in the last three because race car. So anyway, yeah, that's pretty much it. Only other thing is, like I said, I'm getting it ready for turkey season. So we got a choke. Some of you guys may be asking, "Oh, what about the plug?" Well, I went to our good friends at Cabela's and purchased a plug. Like I said, I'm not an expert on shotguns, don't know much about them. I just know how to shoot them really well. I was a very good shot with like skeet and trap shooting, but I never owned my own shotgun to do it with. I always borrowed someone else's. So you probably just saw me jump the gun on that. This is the same procedure to do it on this gun as well, so you're not really missing much. So to take the barrel off of this thing to access where you would put a plug, you just take this bad boy off, you unscrew this, and pull the barrel up. Just like that. And ooh, guess what? If we really, really, really wanted to, I could take this barrel, put it on that, on the 500 here, and I could have a longer barreled Mossberg 500, which is kind of cool. But the thing is, with it being a longer magazine tube, I would have to have a longer plug. But that's actually not a big deal, because let me show you this. So to get your plug out of this, a lot of times you can just shake it out, but you can actually load some shells in here to help push it out. But mine doesn't have any of the O-rings on it. That's my plug. Some of you may be like, "Where'd you buy that?" I didn't buy this. This is a old plastic clothes hanger. I've seen people make them out of arrows, sticks, whatever. Game warden catches you hunting turkey, and he can load more than two shells in the magazine, you're gonna get a fat fine. So I made this because the plug I bought at Cabela's, not only did it not fit into this small hole at the end of the magazine, it was too short anyway, because it was shorter than this. So you could take a clothes hanger and make you one, as long as it's pretty sturdy. I would have to make a longer one for the 500 here, but I could technically put this barrel on here, put a longer plug, and take the 500 and have my nice tang safety and all that good stuff. I'm not going to do that. They're going to shoot virtually the same. It's not worth it. Not worth the time. I can just leave this in here, make this my permanent turkey gun, and use the 500 as my home defense gun, and that's it. That's really all there is to it. To get the barrel back on, you may have to half cock it a little bit just to help persuade it. Then just slide the barrel back into its home, and and then start screwing it back down. May have to fiddle with it just a hair, but super simple. And that's what I love about the Mossberg. Not trying to, you know, come off as a Mossberg fanboy like I am with Glocks and everything like that and Rugers, but Mossberg makes a really, really nice shotgun for the money. So, Remington, sure, they make great shotguns too. What is it? Beretta? Yeah. Or a Benelli? You know, all the big trap guys in high school had that those kind. But for me, I'd go to war with this thing and not think twice about it. I really love the way it feels in the hand. It comes up to the shoulder good. It's lightweight. It's durable. I mean, I'd rather have this than one of those, you know, $600 Benellis or whatever that people use just for trap shooting. Anyway, yeah. Yeah, super duper nice. Recommend it to anyone. Before we go, let's ghost the trigger. Triggers are a little bit heavier on shotguns. You can get lighter ones for sure, but you kind of want a heavier trigger on a shotgun. It's real robust. It's real, real mechanical. Not saying that rifles aren't mechanical, but this is just, it's a different animal, and I love it, you know? This is a muscle car versus like a Ferrari, you know what I mean? So, let's see. Probably, 3 mil of take up. A little bit of creep. Honestly, not as heavy as I remember. Of course, I've been working out, you know, pumping iron. So, you know, I may just be a beast and can't feel it anymore. Let's see. Honestly, that's way less than what I thought. I actually talked it up to be a little bit heavier than that. Maybe 4 pounds, maybe. Lighter than that 1911 that I shot, for sure. Really light trigger, honestly. That's kind of scary. That much take up. Yeah, maybe 4 pounds. Maybe 4.5. Let's try it on the Maverick 88. Let's see if it's any different whatsoever. Let's see. Safety off. Yeah, heavier. Maybe that's what I was thinking of. That's about a, you know, maybe a 6 pound trigger for sure. Yeah, that's about 6 pounds, a little bit heavier. But kind of no surprise either. And I also don't know the age of this Mossberg Maverick 88. I don't know how old it is. I could probably look up the serial number or something and figure that out. But trading for a couple of 12-inch subwoofers, I'm happy with it. You know, I got something I could use, something that wasn't going to lose its value as much over time. I could probably still turn around and sell that thing for probably about $150 if I wanted to. It's probably never going to go below that price point. And that's why I like having guns. They're something that you can use. They're useful. They're just, I don't know. I just love, you know, the mechanics behind them and all that good stuff. But at the same time, they're also a wonderful investment because they really don't go down in price. In fact, they can go up in price by, you know, large factors, especially in times of crisis. Not telling you to price gouge or anything like that, but I mean, when shit hits the fan, no one's going to care about how much money you got. They're going to care about stuff like this. So, food for thought. So anyway, that is the review of the Mossberg 500. I can't recommend it enough. Would I own a Remington? Yeah, 100%. Yeah, for sure. But I am really sold on the Mossberg 500 on the Mossberg brand, you know, just because of how ergonomically correct I feel that it is. I love it. There's really nothing else to say. I love this shotgun. It's great. It's my second favorite shotgun. So, with that being said, you guys, like I said, you know, again, I super duper apologize for not uploading videos regularly to this channel. I was really, really getting at it hard, you know, not that long ago, but like I said, life changes and things take priority over stuff like this. But I won't be back in the full swing of things for a while, but I do have some other shooting videos that I filmed a while back that I'm going to be editing and uploading, so that way you guys can get up to speed on what's been going on and how the Creedmoor's doing and a few other things. So With that being said, hope you guys have been doing well. Hope you guys haven't suffered too much because of this virus thing. I hope that you've been able to still make money, and hope that you and your loved ones have been healthy and all that good stuff. So, you know, God bless you. God bless America. And the question for this video, I can't even remember what my last question was. I think I asked you guys in my last video, or the video before that, like what your favorite movie was. So just because I can't think of anything else off the top of my head, how old were you when you shot your first shotgun or received your first shotgun? How old were you? When the first time I shot a shotgun, I was probably about 7 years old. I was about 7 years old because my grandfather was still alive. So he didn't die when I was seven, but I just distinctly remember us, you know, going out and shooting like Coke cans out by the railroad tracks by my grandparents' house. And I remember my dad told me exactly how to aim this thing, and he told me how hard it was gonna kick. And this 20-gauge single-shot shotgun, the New England firearm shotgun, I was, like, gripping it really hard, and I was like, boom! And it didn't kick nearly as hard as I thought. I was, like, I was braced up. I was ready for hell. And I obliterated this Coke can. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Post your answers in the comment section below. And I really appreciate you guys checking out the channel. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care and have a great night. Thank you.